Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Father Wes Hudin from Our Lady of Częstochowa. We are gathered here to celebrate the funeral of our deceased Dominika Komorowski. Niech będzie pochwalony Jezus Chrystus. Zgromadziliśmy się tutaj, aby pożegnać naszą siostrę Dominikę, polecać ją Bożemu miłosierdziu. Będziemy prosili miłosiernego Pana, aby przyjął ją do swojej chwały. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. My brothers and sisters, we believe that our dwelling on earth is but for a time, and that our true home is in heaven. We gather in faith to pray for our sister Dominika, who has been called to live forever in the dwelling place prepared for all God's faithful. Boże, Ty sprawiłeś, że Twój Syn zwyciężył śmierć i wstąpił do nieba. Daj Twojej zmarłej służebnicy udział w Jego zmartwychwstaniu nad śmiercią, aby mogła na wieki oglądać Ciebie, swojego Stwórcę i Odkupiciela, przez Chrystusa, Pana naszego.
Amen.
O God, to whom mercy and forgiveness belong, hear our prayers on behalf of your servant Dominika, whom you have called out of this world, and because she has put her hope and trust in you, command that she may be carried safely home to heaven and come to enjoy your eternal reward. We ask this to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. A reading from the second letter of Paul to the Corinthians. We know that when the tent that we live in on earth is folded up, there is a house built by God for us, an everlasting home not made by human hands in the heavens. We are always full of confidence then when we remember that to live in the body means to be exiled from the Lord, going as we do by faith and not by sight. We are full of confidence, I say, and actually want to be exiled from the body and make our home with the Lord. Whether we are living in the body or exiled from it, we are intent on pleasing Him. For all the truth about us will be brought out in the law court of Christ, and each of us will get what he deserves for the things he did in the body, good and bad. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The response from your psalm is, "The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where He gives me repose. Near restful waters He leads me to revive my drooping spirit. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. He guides me along the right path. He is truth to His name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil. My cup is overflowing. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want." Czytanie z listu świętego Pawła Apostoła do Rzymian. Bracia, nikt z nas nie żyje dla siebie i nikt nie umiera dla siebie. Jeżeli bowiem żyjemy, żyjemy dla Pana. Jeżeli zaś umieramy, umieramy dla Pana. I w życiu więcej w śmierci należymy do Pana. Po to bowiem Chrystus umarł i powrócił do życia, aby zapanować tak nad umarłymi, jak i nad żywymi. Oto Słowo Boże. Please stand. The Lord be with you.
And also with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your heart be troubled. Trust in God still, and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I am going to prepare a place for you. And after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going?" Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where are you going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." Jezus powiedział do tłumów, "Ja jestem chlebem żywym, który stąpił z nieba. Jeśli kto spożywa ten chleb, będzie żył na wieki. Chlebem, który ja dam, jest moje życie, moje ciało za życie świata." Sprzeczali się między sobą, mówiąc, jak on może dać nam swoje ciało do spożycia. Rzekł do nich Jezus, "Zaprawdę, zaprawdę powiadam wam, jeżeli nie będziecie spożywali ciała Syna Człowieczego i nie będziecie pili krwi Jego, nie będziecie mieli życia w sobie. Kto spożywa moje ciało i pije moją krew, ma życie wieczne, a ja go wskrzeszę w dniu ostatecznym. Ciało moje jest prawdziwym pokarmem, a krew moja jest prawdziwym napojem. Kto spożywa moje ciało i krew moją pije, trwa we mnie, a ja w nim. Jak mnie posłał żyjący Ojciec, a ja żyję przez Ojca, tak i ten, kto mnie spożywa, będzie żył przeze mnie. To jest chleb, który z nieba stąpił. Nie są taki jak ten, który jedli wasi przodkowie, a poumierali. Kto spożywa ten chleb, będzie żył na wieki." Oto Słowo Pańskie.
Chwała Tobie, Chryste.
My dear brothers and sisters, we gather here in this chapel to celebrate the funeral of our deceased Dominika. And as we heard from the liturgy of the word, the life of people is changing, not finished. There is no end on the life. As Christians, we believe it. Jesus promised, God promised us to live forever in his kingdom. But before this, there is a period of time we have to live here as our pilgrims, preparing ourselves for the eternal life. This life here on this earth is a gift given to us by God to live according to his will, according to his commandments, to gain a lot of graces from him, to be better, to be a good man, to be a good woman, to be a good witness of life, of faith. Today we are here to thank God for the life of our sister Dominika, short life. But we never know when God is calling us to meet him. We never know when he is calling us to finish this pilgrimage on earth. It was the same with our sister Dominika. Short life given to her is a symbol of the short pilgrimage, preparing for meeting with Christ, our Savior, our God. Today we are here also to pray and ask His mercy, because we as human beings, we are also tempted by the sins, and we committed them. And today we are here to intercede for our sister Dominika, asking God be merciful, forgive her sins, and welcome her into your kingdom in heaven. We are here as those who are close to her, as parents, as those who are friends, family. We mourn because of this tragic moment, but we believe that this moment gives us an opportunity to reflect upon our own life, asking ourselves, are we ready to meet Jesus Christ? Are we ready to experience this moment of death, death of the body? Let us think about it. Jesus is giving us another opportunity to change our life, to change our relationship with Him. He's giving us a lot of moments and situations in our life to seek Him, to experience His presence with us. When we meet others, we feel some relationship with that person. It's the same when we believe. We feel the same. Jesus is present with us. Today also we are here to support the family, those who are mourning and grieving because of this unexpected death. Thank you everybody who come, being here with this prayer, supporting the family with prayer, with good words, with being present here for this moment. Also, we are here to listen to the words of God, as Jesus said to His disciples today, do not be afraid. Do not let your heart be troubled. I'm going to prepare the place in my Father's house, and I will be back to take you when I am, to take you and to open the gates of heaven for you. It's the moment when we celebrate this funeral. It's the moment when Jesus is coming to say to her, welcome into my kingdom. The soul is a gift from God. The soul of our sister Dominika is alive. I remember some visits to the people when I went to visit elderly or some families. When I entered the house, I saw a lot of pictures, you know, on the counter. And I thought, why people are putting the pictures on it? Because people want to remember. Because always when we see the face or the picture with members of family, we think, oh, they were beautiful, they were very good people, you know, and it is for us also a good moment when we remember them, not only because we remember some situations from the past, but it is a good opportunity to ask, to pray, Jesus, Jesus, please welcome her into your life. As we see, you know, this exposition here, few pictures from the life of our sister Dominika, they remind us it was very good life, but short. And few of you may say, I know, I experienced her presence, I experienced her smiling, I experienced a lot of good things from her. Now it's time to say thank you, Dominika. Thank you for your life, thank you for your smiling, thank you for everything you gave us. Brothers and sisters, this is our life. Also, you know, there is a good tradition to remember her name in your prayer. As I observe some people, you know, coming to the cemetery to visit the grave, you know, to put some lights, to put some flowers. It means that we remember also them as our loved one, you know, giving them the sign we remember and we hope to meet together after our life here on this earth. Brothers and sisters, this is a good moment for us to take this opportunity to remember her in our daily life. Sometimes when we sit down having coffee or cake, having some barbecue, being together the backyard, it is good to say, remember her, she was good. And because of these memories, we are strengthened by God and we are giving more gifts to believe that we will meet her in His kingdom in heaven. And today, as I said at the beginning, we are very thankful to God for her life, for her smiling. I see her on the front of this booklet, very smiling girl, woman. I think this smiling gave us the motive to live better. If we are very close to others, we show our relationship with some signs. Smiling is probably the best sign of our love to the others. Then, now, I know we are covered with the mask, but I would like to ask everybody to smile to her now, giving her the sign, we remember you, we pray for you, we want to remember you forever. Moi drodzy, tak jak powiedziałem, znakiem naszej relacji z tymi, którzy żyli, a już nie żyją, jest uśmiech. Uśmiech, który wyraża naszą relację do drugiego człowieka. Uśmiech, który wyraża naszą wdzięczność do drugiego człowieka. Uśmiech, który pozwala nam wierzyć, że osoba uśmiechająca się do nas wyraża także miłość. Dlatego dziś spróbujmy uśmiechnąć się do naszej siostry Dominiki, dziękując jej za wszystko, co zostawiła dla nas, za jej życie, za przykład wiary, za przykład miłości do rodziców, do innych. To są znaki, które pozwalają nam ufać, że jej życie, które skończyło się tutaj na ziemi, nie skończyło się. Skończyło się życie jej ciała, natomiast wierzymy, że ona żyje w Królestwie Niebieskim. Dlatego jesteśmy tutaj, aby modlić się za jej duszę i prosić Boga, aby odpuścił jej grzechy i przyjął ją do swojej chwały w niebie. Moi drodzy, jesteśmy też tutaj wyrażając nasz żal z tego powodu, że to życie skończyło się za wcześnie. I wyrażamy także nasze współczucie względem najbliższych, rodziny, tych, którzy byli bliscy sercu Dominiki. Myślę, że nasza obecność jest wyrazem także naszej wiary w nieśmiertelność duszy, bo wierzymy, że Bóg, że Jezus, który dzisiaj mówi do apostołów, idę, aby przygotować wam miejsce w domu mojego Ojca, ale wrócę po was. I my dzisiaj doświadczamy tego powrotu Jezusa Chrystusa po to, aby jeszcze bardziej go pokochać, po to, aby jeszcze bardziej mu zaufać. Dziękujemy więc za dar życia naszej siostry Dominiki i prośmy o życie wieczne dla niej przez przyczynę naszej Matki Maryi. Jesus, our Savior, has gone before us and prepared a place for us in our Father's house. We now place our trust in Him and say, Christ Jesus, you are the way and the truth and the life. Welcome our sister Dominika to the place you have prepared for her in the Father's house. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Jesus Christ, You are the glory of believers and the life of the just. Admit Dominika into the company of those who have gone before her and are numbered among your saints in glory. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Christ Jesus, you will draw all things to yourself. Forgive the sins of our sister and grant that she may live in your peace forever. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Christ Jesus, you nourished our sister with your body and blood during her pilgrimage on earth. May she delight in the rich fare you provide at the banquet table in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Módlmy się za naszą zmarłą Dominikę, aby aniołowie Pańscy wprowadzili ją do raju. Ciebie prosimy.
Wysłuchaj nas, Panie.
Módlmy się za rodzinę pogrążoną w żałobie, aby mężnie znosiła rozłąkę i kiedy spotkała się ze zmarłą w Ojczyźnie Wiecznej. Ciebie prosimy.
Wysłuchaj nas, Panie.
Módlmy się za nas, tutaj wszystkich zgromadzonych, abyśmy przygotowali się na spotkanie z Bogiem. Ciebie prosimy.
Wysłuchaj nas, Panie.
Módlmy się za wszystkich wiernych zmarłych, aby Bóg wprowadził ich do wiecznej światłości. Ciebie prosimy.
Wysłuchaj nas, Panie.
With longing for our heavenly homeland, let us pray as Jesus Christ taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Into your hand, O Lord, we humbly entrust our sister Dominika. In this life, you embraced her with your tender love. Deliver her now from every evil, and bid her enter eternal rest. The old order has passed away. Welcome her into paradise, where there will be no sorrow, no weeping, no pain, but the fullness of peace and joy with your Son and the Holy Spirit forever and ever.
Amen.
Lord, Dominika is gone from this earthly dwelling and has left behind those who mourn her absence. Grant that as we grieve for our sister, we may hold her memory dear and live in hope of the eternal kingdom where you live, where you will bring us together again. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Blessed are those who have died in the Lord. Let them rest from their labors, for their good deeds go with them. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace of Christ. Thanks
be to God.
Dobry Jezu, nasz Panie, najej wieczne, spoczywaj. Dobry Jezu, a nasz Panie, najej wieczne, spoczywaj. Dobry Jezu, a nasz Panie, najej wieczne, spoczywaj. Jesus Christus.
Amen.
Thank you, everybody, for being here, for your prayers. Thank you, the members of family, being here. We support you, we keep you in our prayer.
Good friend Dominika was unable to be here, so she did write something that she wanted to spoke into Dominika. Due to the times being what they are, I am not able to physically be there to mourn the loss of my friend the way I want to. These words are so difficult to write, knowing I cannot be there. Dominika was beautiful, obviously on the outside, but her heart was the most beautiful. She showed me this countless ways throughout our friendship. Dominika was not only my friend, but my family. Our memories started at 10 years old when we met at St. Mary's Choir School. We went off to John 2 together, where our bond strengthened. We were always so silly together. I remember numerous sleepovers where we giggled, sang, and talked about boys until the morning. She forced me to watch scary movies, and even trapped me on the couch so I couldn't leave. During a difficult time in my life, Dominika, her mom, and Roman took me into their home and treated me as one of their own. This is when we shared a room, and I learned she spoke Polish in her sleep. We laughed, fought, had fun, got irritated with each other, and became sisters. Lord help me if I forgot to take 90210. Dominika was a beautiful dancer. I remember going to her recital and watching her do the things she was great at and loved. She attempted to teach me, but I remember her putting her hand on her forehead and shaking her head at me. I attempted to take her running, and then it was my turn to shake my head at her. Dom and I were so different, yet the bond we have lasted all these years. Back when there were no cell phones, we wrote notes, we signed those notes, best friends for life and beyond. It takes on new meaning now that we are in the beyond stage. It's too soon, and I'm so sad that life on earth was so short for her. Dominika, I will miss you. I will miss your sweetness, your laughter, your voice, and your kindness. Our memories will stay with me forever, and I love you. Your sister, Rachel. Anna, you always joked that I was your second daughter. I hope you continue to feel that way. You know I love you, and will do anything I can to help you through this. The first chance I get, Ty and I will come to Canada and give the hugs that are needed. I love you, and hope to hug you soon, your second daughter, Rachel.
Hello everyone, I'm Paul. I was friends with Dominika and worked with her in the year 2000 at the bar downtown. We had a lot of fun, and we started talking again in December. Had a lot of fun from January until now, and I loved her and I'll miss her, and it's unreal, but she's still around, and I just have to say hi to her when we think she's around. Thank you everyone for coming.
Ladies and gentlemen, this does conclude our service here today in our chapel. Before everyone goes their separate ways, for those of you who would like to come forward and place their hand on top of Dominika's casket, you're more than welcome to do so. And any questions or concerns, please ask. Thank you.